The idea of getting chip implants is sometimes a little shocking to people. Someone called me Electric Jesus. Yeah, I like to think I have cyborg upgrades. I kind of view it as what it could be. I think that starts with the curious mind.
Microchip implants have been used in the medical field for decades, but now an estimated 100,000 people worldwide have non-medically necessary chip implants, sometimes called biohacking.
Not everyone gets excited when I think about like, oh, this is a chip implant. It's not for everyone, but it doesn't have to be.
The chips are no bigger than a grain of rice.
At least here in the US, there's an idea of microchipping your dog or your pet. So if they're lost, you can take them back to the vet and they can scan them, and it has like ID contact information of the owner. It is essentially the same thing. It's about the size of a grain of cooked rice. The implant is just in a hollow injectable needle.
One big deep breath. And out.
And it just goes underneath the skin. It's just like going to get a piercing. I originally wanted to get one because it gave you access control to unlock your door.
Well, I don't have to carry keys anymore. This is my front door. It's locked. This is the Samsung keypad. I cannot get in. All I have to do, just take my transponder implant, put it there, open. Voila.
I was very curious like how that worked, what else you could do with it, how much data you could actually store on it. So I have three chip implants so far. I have one in the webbing of my hand, one in the top of my hand, and one in my forearm. Started with the one in the webbing in my hand. Essentially, they're all RFID or NFC, which is just this near field communication. It's not connected to the internet. That's what a lot of people think it does. It is not active, meaning it doesn't have a battery in me. It's not always putting out a signal. It is passive. I have my contact info linked to this one specifically. And the nice thing about having the LED pops up and shows where it is in your reader, and then it will take you to my webpage. Always encourage us, like if we were curious, like whenever I would get new toys, like I would want to take them apart to figure out like how do they work, how do they move. I got to make and blow up stuff and have little electricity like science projects, and absolutely loved that part of my childhood. My day walker job is as a software engineer in the gaming industry. And by night, I make cosplay, I work on Lego, I do 3D printing, I do CNC, I do ethical satellite hacking. I don't consider myself an artistic person or creative without the use of like any type of technology. I love making cosplay stuff. Like if I could have my chip implant work with a cosplay prop so I could pick it up and it would light up, that would be amazing. My idea was like, all right, this is probably not the worst thing I've put in my body. What else can I do with these implants? And that led to the journey of getting the Tesla implant and kind of making my own. I haven't seen anyone do this before. It's not something you can just go to the internet and type into a search engine. So when I got my car, they came with these valet keys, and very similar people see, maybe it looks like a hotel key, but there is a NFC chip inside of this card. But the biggest thing for this was the antenna, and I needed the antenna to be able to read and communicate, because same as this and same as my chip implants, there is no, it is passive. There's no battery in this. So you have to be very, very close. So for scale reference, this is the size of the other two chip implants that I currently have in my body. The Tesla one for scale is the size of this Lego minifig. Not the width, but the length of it. So I took the original Tesla valet card and I melted it down in acetone. I extracted the chip that was in the card and then created my own antenna and then encased that in a biopolymer, which is safe for the body, and then had that injected underneath the dermal layer of my skin. Sometimes it's kind of hard to tell, but you tap it here and then you would open the door like that. Key is in me, so I would tap behind the cup holder to authenticate, and then I would be able to drive once I put on my seatbelt. So when I worked on the Tesla hack, I got some backlash from this wonderful place called the internet. Some people said, oh, so now I don't have to steal your car keys, I can just chop off my arm. I'm like, sure, murder and Grand Theft Auto, like, it's just very hard when people send you hate mail. Somebody sent me ripped out pages from the Christian Bible, which already seems malicious. So the part that they highlighted and sent and said, unless he had the mark, which is the name of the beast or the number of his name, this is called for wisdom. If anyone has insight, let him calculate the number of the beast, for it is man's number. His number is 666. A woman clothed with a sun, with the moon under her feet and a crown of 12 stars on her head. She was pregnant and cried out in pain as she was about to give birth. The dragon stood in front of the woman who was about to give birth so that he might devour her first child the moment it was born. She gave birth to a son, a male child, who would rule all the nations with an iron scepter. So they sent me a pregnancy test, essentially saying that I'm like the downfall of this woman and the dragon or something. I don't know. Very, very weird. Then followed by like really nice stuff from little girls that I inspired for STEM or for Lego stuff. Like the letter from like the kids, like that's neat. Like when people say like, hey, you inspired my kids or you inspired my little girl to, that they can dress up and, you know, have representation of what they want to be and still do the things they love. That's pretty neat. So I can see where we're going. So we're heading to get chip implants with Kat. This chip will do everything from payments to authentication to UbiKey, two-factor authentication, and your Tesla. I did do some measurement on this chip size. It is not quite as big as a Lego minifig, but it is in a diameter, so it's a circle. I think it's like 22 millimeters. So I'm assuming it will have to be done with some incisions or stitches. Don't typically like pain. I know it seems ironic, but when you want something, the pain is very different, I feel.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you in real life.
We have a lot of mutual friends who are in cybersecurity or InfoSec and stuff.
Yeah.
No, I'm a developer advocate.
Oh wait, I think I didn't know that.
Go first, that way Kat, we can have shared trauma.
Thank you, I appreciate it. You're being a real trooper, Amy.
I can take the pain. Was worse watching it before and knowing, or no?
No, it wasn't bad at all watching you. My friend Charlotte has a couple of implants too, and she's extremely interested in the larger ones. She doesn't know exactly what I'm getting, she just knows I'm getting a bigger one than she has. I'm interested to see if TSA has anything to say about this tomorrow?
If this one's any bigger?
Yeah, because this one's so much bigger, like...
Yeah, yeah. That's what I would be curious about. Right. Let me know how that goes.
I will, yeah.
Most chips can be installed quickly with an injector or a piercing needle, but the new chips that Amy and Kat are getting are a larger experimental chip that require an incision and stitches.
We did the damn thing. I'm so excited.
I know. He's like, does the LED work yet? I'm like, probably not. I'm like too bloody.
Yeah, too bloody, too swollen.
Look, I'm red.
Ah!
Oh, it's already way better than my Tesla one. The LED indicator is like super helpful.
Yeah, it's flashing green.
It's so cute. Let me see.
That's so dope. Yeah, for sure.
It's not a new technology. Like, it's been around a very, very long time.
Yeah. And having these things is why the, like, the people who think that they're sneaking, like, 5G tracking chips into vaccines.
Be like, I wish.
I wish. I wish. Holy crap. People always think that those chips are, like, connected to the internet at all times, right? Like, they're powered and they are connected to the internet and somebody's tracking you remotely. Oh, my God.
that would be so sick.
Well, that's what...
Like, sign me up.
There's also been... I've had good discussions with people. I'm like, all right, no, it doesn't connect to the internet. But if it did, would you put one in, like, your kids or something like that? Like, is that... And then that brings up thing, whether it's an invasion of privacy, yeah, or is it, like, a security, like, the moral, ethical... I guess there's some political arguments that come in there.
I do think that's unethical because it's too easy to abuse.
But that, right? but that's the point. Like, yeah, having those good conversations come from this, I feel.
For sure.
Or like just putting like a different thought process in people's mind, at least. Like, be like, I'm not trying to like put one in you or like get you to join my non-cult, which, but yeah.
No, this thing is like, for me, it's strictly like, it is a security thing. Because if you have to cut off my arm to like get my one-time passwords, then
I know,
baby, you earned it.
That's what people say for my car. They'd be like, oh, so now we have to like cut off your arm and it's Grand Arm Auto or something. I was like, yes, well, one becomes like murder and one is like just like stealing my keys.
Yeah. But also it's just kind of cool.
Oh, it also has an LED.
Yeah.
It's so cute.
It's just cool.
Some people think it's weird to have a chip implant, but in some way, I look at the beauty industry. I see ads on social media all the time, like, you know, it's so common now for women to have Botox and filler, and it's considered the sign of beauty. And even in the like plastic surgery, I think it's so interesting that some of those things are totally acceptable and normal, but to have a chip implant is like, oh my gosh, it's not normal. You see how I'm flashing red? There we go. If I'm trying to convince you to get a chip implant, like, it's ultimately your choice. I'm not trying to like win you over to my side. If I can just educate you and you can make your own informed decision, then I've already like done something to get you thinking in a different way.